from Learning Science and Technologies on how teacher leadership develops and its effects on ICT reform for educational improvement.
Okay, good afternoon everyone. I'm the one who's standing between you and the teacher. Okay, so I'll make it short and sweet. Yes, if someone were to share and mention this word Apple, what comes to your mind? Okay, to some people, maybe we'll get some audience to tell us, what comes to your mind when we say Apple?
Apple computers.
Anything else?
Apple.
The fruit. Yes, and it could be the latest on YouTube, right? The pineapple pen, Apple. Okay, now, so that shows that one word can actually make a lot of difference in different contexts. So likewise, teacher leader, right? When someone mentioned the word teacher leader to you, right, such a schizophrenic kind of term, you know? How can you be a teacher and a leader? Right. So that's what my study is all about. Okay, what is a teacher leader and who's a teacher leader? Right, that's something which I want to clarify. Now, just like Apple, right? If it is in the food store, right? Even within in the food store, you have different types of apple. You have the Royal Gala, you have the Red Delicious, and you have Fuji, not the mountain. Okay, and you also have Macintosh, okay, which is both the Apple as well as a computer, right? So, in order to scope the study down, okay, I've decided to put it inside the context, okay, which is what I'm most familiar with, and that is the ICT context. So, I'm not referring to any teacher or any other teacher leadership, okay? I'm only referring to teacher leadership in the ICT context. Now, you may ask me, why? Why do you want to study ICT? Now, one of my earlier colleagues has already mentioned, almost everybody is aware, you know, you're using ICT now, right? Yeah, every single moment, we're all in this digital age, right? And information world, you know, is ICT is something that we live and we breathe, and it's something truly important, which many nations in the world are aware of. Okay, so much so that they have national ICT master plans. And for example, like in Singapore, ours is in the fourth. And in South Korea, theirs is actually in the fifth already. Yeah, so therefore, it is so important and so timely that there should be a study on ICT reforms for educational improvement. Now, then the question is, why teacher leadership, right? Because when the principal is not in school, who's the one who's mending the fault, right? That's the teachers, right? So I'm looking at teachers who are exhibiting teacher leadership practices. So in my study, I'll be looking at, I'm using a case study approach, I'm using the maximum variation sampling approach, selection. Okay, I'll be choosing four cases, and these four cases will be according to what literature informs me, right? Because it says that in the whole debate of teacher leadership, it's between formal as well as informal, okay? Whether if they have a position or don't have a position. And in Singapore, because it's such a hierarchical system, right, it's so important to look at years of experience. So that's what my study is about. Thank you.